Can you?
Yeah, bro.
Three, go ahead. Add any more weight?
I can clean it, bro.
Nice.
Clean up the tire. Today it's gonna be about functional training. Today we're gonna do some Olympic lifting with my boy right here. He's also my roommate and we're matching our shirts. This was not planned at all, so don't judge us. But moving on, let's hand it over to him and let him introduce himself, and then we'll start off with some basic Olympic lifting questions. Over to you.
Hey guys, my name is James. I'm currently a junior at Purdue. I am a competitive Olympic weightlifter, and a lot of people get confused whenever I tell them I'm an Olympic weightlifter because they think I went to the Olympics, and they're like, oh, what year did you go? Oh, that's awesome, dude. But Olympic weightlifting is the name of the sport. It is two movements, the snatch and the clean and jerk, which we'll get to later.
Okay, solid. So when did you start weightlifting? And before you started weightlifting, did you used to lift, or did you just like straight up start from weightlifting?
So yeah, I'm currently a junior, and I started Olympic lifting around the summer of my freshman year. The end of my freshman year, so it's almost been 2 years now of just strictly Olympic lifting. But before, I would just do a regular bodybuilding bro split, which would be chest and back on Monday, arms and legs on Tuesday, and shoulders Wednesday, and just repeat. And then before that, I had more of an athletic background playing sports. Yeah, that's just my favorite.
What is Olympic lifting?
So Olympic lifting is two movement sport. So Olympic weightlifting is a sport in the Olympics. They compete every 4 years. The two movements are snatch and a clean and jerk. Snatch is where you take the barbell from the floor to overhead in one fluid movement. And the clean and jerk is a two-part movement in one movement where you take the bar to your shoulders and you squat it up, and then you take the bar from your shoulders to overhead. The clean would be where you take the barbell from the floor to your shoulders, and the jerk would be when you take it from your shoulders to overhead.
Okay. So, how about you tell us about the meets you have done? Like, what was your first meet, and compared to that, how were your numbers in the last meet, and like, how did you progress over the years? Like, a bit about your background in Olympic lifting.
So, I have done three competitive weightlifting meets under USAW, which is a national organization. Like USATF, which is USA Track and Field, or USA Swimming. And the three meets I've done nationally are Junior Nationals, the AO Series at Grand Rapids, Michigan, and the AO Series at the Arnold. Other than that, I've done local competitions almost once every 2 months. As a beginner in Olympic lifting, you would want to compete pretty much once every 2 months just to keep on it. And yeah, I've done local meets here and then.
Olympic lifting has weight classes like bodybuilding, or basically most of the sports like strongman have weight classes too. How does the weight classes work in Olympic lifting? Do you guys go by kilograms, by pounds, or is there a height with that? Because like bodybuilding is height related, so how's the weight class system working?
Yeah, so the weight classes in weightlifting, there are for both men and women, there are 8 weight classes. Women ranging from 48 kilograms to 90 plus, and men from 52 to 105 plus. And they count in kilograms because it's an international sport for the Olympics, so they count in kilograms worldwide, not just the US, it would be pounds. And for height, there are no height requirements. You could be 6 feet tall and in the lightest weight class, but obviously that's not advantageous for you. But yeah, there's no height requirements.
Okay, solid. So if someone has been in Olympic lifting for a while, like they think they are confident with their form and stuff and they won't fail, should they aim for a specific numbers for their first meet, or just do a meet so get an idea about it?
Yeah, so for a competitive weightlifter, your first meet should not matter about the numbers at all. That is the last thing that should be on your mind. And also, weight classes should not be a focus for your first meet. Just Just go show up, have fun, be ready to lift. The most important thing when you compete is to go 6 for 6, which means to hit all your lifts. In the sport of weightlifting, you get 6 attempts, 3 for the snatch, 3 for the clean and jerk, and you don't want to go to hit the specific number, because if you don't hit that number, then your performance is just based on, oh, if I hit this number, I did good. If I didn't, I did bad. Just go hit 6 for 6 and just have fun, and then worry about all the numbers in your future goals.
So what are we doing today? I know it's like learning clean and jerk and snatch is a long procedure. So what's a couple of things you're going to do like that anyone can incorporate in their basic routine just for mobility and like functional strength, you know?
So both the snatch and the clean and jerk, they require a lot of technique from the floor. So today we're just going to be learning to hang power clean and power jerk.
Okay.
This makes it simple because the hang power clean and jerk doesn't require a lot of technique. It focuses all about your explosiveness, and the power jerk is a simple movement where you just get the bar overhead.
Okay, solid. So I wanted to keep it short because there's way more detail into Olympic lifting, but it's always good to sort of scratch the surface before doing something. So that's basically a rough idea about what Olympic lifting is. I'm gonna link his Instagram down in the description box, so DM him. I think you'll be fine helping people if they want to know more. So hit him up, go like his page, and we're gonna go lift now. But before we train, we gotta stretch, because
we're gonna be doing a full body stretch since Olympic lifting is a full body movement. And now we're going to do hip circles. So just 5 on. Now we're going to go down to the floor and do a butterfly stretch.
This is going to be hard for me because I hurt my ankle. If you didn't watch my video, go watch my video of ankle yoga.
Stretch our quads. And now we're going to do the shoulder stretch right here, shoulder and lat stretch. And now, step that I'm going to teach Ronald here to do the movements are a simple kettlebell swing. And what you want to do is just sit your feet a little shoulder width or a little past if you want. It's just whatever's comfortable with you. Rest your arms, make sure they're relaxed, that's the key. Keep it in your hip right here. Now you want to bend over and then squeeze your glutes and let the kettlebell swing up. And relax your arms so that you activate your glutes and work your core, just like that. And why this is our first step is because you want to activate your glutes, activate your core, warm up your shoulders, and kind of reinforce the technique of using your hips to move the bar instead of using your arms, which is why relaxing your arms is really key in this movement. And if you get heavier than, this is just 30 pounds, but if you go heavier to 100 pound kettlebell, you can't just rely on using your arms to swing. You need to use your hips, your lower body, and your legs to move the kettlebell. So for the Olympic lifting movements, you don't want to lose your grip or have your grip be a limiting factor. So the way to grab the bar is a hook grip style. So you have the bar in your palm like this. You put your thumb down and your 2 fingers over your thumb. Some people go 3, some people go 1, but the best way to do it, in my opinion, is to have 2, both your index and your ring finger over your thumb like this. And no, you don't have to squeeze really hard, just have the have them over like this and just relax. So the first step in this is to pick the barbell off of the ground. You wanna have your hook grip, you wanna grab grab the bar. I usually grab the bar thumb inch length from the knurling, but a good place to grab the bar is if your arms are relaxed.
and the bar is resting on your upper thighs or on your hips. The first step would be to lead with the shoulders and descend to the upper knee. You don't want to lead down with your legs. You don't want to do this. You want to lead with your shoulders and get a good hamstring stretch, and that's the first step. Look straight forward, yeah. Okay, so step two after descending would to go back the same way you went down, leading with the shoulders, and shrug. Shrug and extend through your feet just like how you would with a kettlebell swing. So in a kettlebell swing, you would do this type of motion, like that, except with the barbell, you would shrug at the end. So this is how it works.
Looks really good. Yep, but your toes.
We're gonna reincorporate step one and step two. Step one would be descending with the shoulders. Step two would be ascending and shrugging at the top. And we're gonna catch it on our shoulders. Like this. Now, if you can close your fist and grab the barbell, that's the first ideal step. But if you can't, fingertips are okay, as long as your elbows stay high. Oh, fuck. Oh, that hurts. So right now we're just stretching his wrists and his lats so he can get into a proper position for the clean.
He's killing me.
So once you have the bar in this position, after the hang clean, hang power clean, you want to re-rack the bar, and then have a quarter inch dip, about like that, and get the bar overhead using your legs and finishing with the arms like this. Now this movement is not an upper body movement, it is a lower body movement. Use your legs to get the bar overhead, not your arms. Your arms are just like levers, like that. So usually you can do the jerk a lot more weight than what you do a strict press.
Nice, use your legs.
For the interference, me in the game like mad. Catch a bitch on spaz, yeah. Half a meal, for the back end. Phantom grill, hit her, when you back in. Making my money, do flip, 200 girls in the flip. I got a mouth and I dip, pulling the lean like a film. I might go to rehab this year. Put a Draco on my hip, still on my cart in my drip. Fiji water don't slip. 100 round drum, get a shooter's a tip. Make the body do a flip. Fuck the ops, let it rip. It's a blessing. I was broke, but now I'm blessed.
So guys, as you know, unfortunately, I hurt my ankle real bad while I was filming the acro yoga, which was the episode 2 of Training With. And if you want to see how bad it was, I'll put a link in the description, or you can just go to my channel, and it's the second episode of Training With. But because of that, I was not able to perform a couple of more lifts, and it's because ankle is really important in Olympic lifting. James over here is going to tell us a bit more why ankle mobility and like your ankle should be in its best condition to perform all the lifts. So why is ankle really important?
The reason why he couldn't perform the snatch, or in our case it would have been the hang power snatch. In Olympic lifting, your knee will travel in front of your toe, which does put a stretch in your calf and ankle area, and he couldn't just do that, do the stretch. So we just resulted in doing the hang power clean. And then the power jerk was also hurting his ankle because he had to do a jumping motion to get under the bar, and he couldn't do that.
What about the snatch? Why was I not able to perform? Like, I know it would have put a lot of stress on my snatch, but snatch is technically more complicated, right?
Yeah, the snatch requires a lot more technique and timing and mobility, and that was just a lot too much to put in one episode.
So because of my ankle injury, I won't be able to perform a couple more fitness styles which I had in mind. So
I haven't gotten it checked up. It's almost healed, but there's still like a little bit stretch in my Achilles tendon, which kind of hurts. So I'm gonna probably take some time off from like doing all these complicated stuff. And this will be the end of the series, probably, let's call it season one. I might have a bonus episode dropping, which is something you will never see coming. It will be dropping sometime soon, but until then, I have really fun content lined up.
So even though we couldn't do many of the movements, this video came out pretty good. He was able to do a lot of the things that I had planned for him. So stay tuned for next Wednesday's video. Give him a like, subscribe, and comment.
Question. Ain't no fucking second guess. No, we in the game like Madden.